So let's start with the setup environment. Just let me start my system, log in it. Do you want to try on your system, or shall I explain you on my system and then you will going to do it?
I think we can parallelly do, right?
Okay. Yeah. So as I mentioned you, see, the first step is you need to go to the Cloud9. You can go to the AWS console and search about the Cloud9. You can go here, Cloud9, you can search it. And once you get it, you can just click on this. Once you click on this, you will get search environment, as you can see. Hope you are getting like this on the screen, right? I repeat once again, just go to the console of AWS. Once you go to the console of AWS, just type here Cloud9. And once you click on this, it will appear you like this. Once you done this, then click on this create environment. Once you click on this create environment, now here you need to describe the configuration setting. Configuration setting in the sense like what name you want to give it, any name you can give it. It depends on you. If you like, based on your name, if you want, you can give it any name you can give it. Like I am taking demo Hackvedar, and I'm giving the description that I am creating. I'm configuring demo Hackvedar. I'm configuring demo Hackvedar. IoT. You can give any description. It's not like what I am giving. It's just for my knowledge I am giving it. You can give anything. So once you give the name and the description, just scroll down. The next, you need to click on this next step. Don't worry about this. It is because of Grammarly it is coming. So click on the next step. Once you are done the next step, as I said you, right? In the example, when I explain you EC2 instances, right? I explain you what are the instances. So here we are doing the same. Here we have created the instances. So here you can see I'm creating a new instance. Create a new EC2 instance for the environment. So here I'm, once I create it, then what are the instance type you want? So here what we were doing, we are just creating a virtual server, or you can say virtual system. Here the difference is that when you create a server in your local system, means when you create a physical server, at that time you need to create it a big, like you need to purchase everything, like 1 TB hard disk, RAM, processor, everything you need to purchase, and you need to create a system. But this is virtual in the sense you will going to create in the cloud. You don't need to create it physically. I mean to say that you need to create on this cloud only. And once you give it the name, once you create a EC2 instances, am I clear till now?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. So once you create this instance type, you can select it, whether you want 1 GB, 1 CPU, 2 GB, 2 CPU, 8 GB, or if you want other, then you can select it and give the other configuration also. But I will going to use this T2 micro. Why there is a reason? Always try to use such configuration that are free. So this is, you can see, free tier eligible, ideal for education, user and exploration. So I will always going to use free one. Why free one? Because if you use any of this, it will going to charge you, means based on that your monthly billing will come. I hope at this much means this much you are aware about it. Like whatever we do, it's just like a cloud. So in this not just like cloud, it is actually the cloud only. In this cloud, it is providing service pay on basis, means how much you have a requirement, based on that you are going to pay, right? Just like what is your qualification, experience, based on that we get a pay, right? So similarly it happens here also, based on our requirement configuration, charges they apply to us. AWS will send you monthly billing on that. So why I will going to use costly one? As of now we are using the demo one, so we will going to use free tier. So that's why I selected it. I want platform Linux operating system, so I selected Amazon Linux 2. And I want that cost saving, means cost should be saved. Like suppose if my server is not in a use for 30 minutes, at least of 30 minutes, I will put it in a hibernate, or you can say in a sleeping mode, where it will going to save some charges. It's just like a saving. And these are the IAM role. IAM role means here you can decide it, who can access this, who cannot. If you click on this, you can get the more detail. But as of now, we don't need to go it there. It's a advanced topic, or it like a, it's a big topic. Like it's just tell you whoever you want to give an access, just like in a company when you want to work, like as I'm working as a data engineer, so as a data engineer I want to get an access of data. So my manager has given me access in the Google, in this like database and storage, so they have given me access to that. But they have not given me access to deployment, because that is DevOps team they do. So you can put a restriction on the access also. So that is why we use this IAM role. We give some role in the sense, just like teacher, student. Teacher role is what? Teaching. He has a some facility, means some features she has available assigned to her. Like she can take a class, she can take an attendance. And what is the role for the student? To study. Similarly, here also the role is provided. Database role, data engineering role, data science role, and instances access role, means you can use the instance. So these are called IAM role. So you don't need to go further in this. After that, you can just click on this next step. Once you click on this, it will going to show you that you will get an update. Once you create this instance, you will get an update on this Cloud9. Cloud9 will not going to do automatic backup. You have to do the backup from your own, or you need to take the services that will help you to take the backup. Backup for what? Backup for the data, right? If every day the data will come, you need to make a backup of that. In case the instance that you have created is fail due to some reason, it get fail, how you're going to handle that? You can handle that in such a way that you can create a backup of the data that you're going to save in this instance. So later on you can save those data in another instance by creating another instance of same configuration, you can save it. Is it clear till now?
It is clear. I just have one stupid question. Why do instances fail?
Instance fail can be any reason. Suppose database fail, if suppose the hard disk get crashed, like suppose natural hazard, obviously, like suppose if your server, this server also you are going to deploy somewhere, right? AWS, Amazon company, they have a server. In case suppose due to fire and all, the server get destroyed, it will impact your virtual instance also, because your instances are saving data in their storage, right? So they create a automatic backup of your data. So in first you are paying to them, right? In case suppose you lost the data, then what is the use of cloud? So they create an automatic backup and replication of the data. So they by default they create three copy of the data. By default they create a three replication. So in case one is lost, they can give you from another one. So this is the advantage of the cloud. But in hard disk, if your system hard disk get crashed, you need to recover the data. That will be really a costly. If you go to the hardware engineer, they will going to charge you heavily in case your data is too important for you. Once you've done this, you can click on this create environment. It will take some time. It will take few seconds to do that. Yeah, so you can see here, this environment is open for you. Okay, I think it's creating by default in EC2. Let me check it. Okay. See, when you will going to start working on that, you can change this region to EC1 at the starting only. You can change this to EC1. In that case, you won't get any error. Let me check whether we are working, because see, based on this region, they have some configuration of the server. So right now we have done with this Cloud9 is started. So let's start running the command. So we have done this part, right? We have created the instances, and now we will going to upload the local files. So what is the next step now? The next step is now you need to upload the key value pair. A key value pair is what? Just to authenticate that this instance you have created, you need to upload it. And how you will get that key value pair? Once you go to this cloud, you click on this key value pair. Just 1 minute. So when you search for the instances, there you will get the options of creating key pair. Are you getting? Just check it. Type the instances here, and then you will get this key pair. Once you click on this key pair, you can see several key pair I have created here. Okay, what this key pair is? Key pair is nothing but it's just like a ID, or you can say a kind of fingerprint for you that tells that cloud that you have created this instance. And it will going to means it is just like they are giving you a certificate, authenticate certificate they are giving you. That certificate, once you upload on this Cloud9 will going to be like Cloud9 will understand that, okay, you are the only person who has created this configuration. Am I clear to you what is key pair?
No, actually, I'm not getting where is key pair.
Click on the instances on that services. Once you click on these instances, you will get this key pair. You will scroll down. Have you searched for instances on the console?
Could you send me the link, the URL?
Are you able to open the console or what?
I'm able to open the console, but I searched instances also.
Can you share your screen? I can help.
Yeah, just a second.
Yeah. I'm just stop sharing and making you host. Dipti, ma'am, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just a second.
Which one? There are two. You have connected twice. Okay, yeah. Which one you are speaking, I am making to that. Yes, ma'am, I have made it.
Is it clear now? Is my screen visible to you?
No. I have made you host. Can you just share it once?
Just a second. Now, can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Scroll down. You see this key pair?
Acha, yeah.
So click on this key pair and click here, create key pair. It is only used to just it. Once you click on this, you give a name and select this PEM extension. Acha, give any name you can give it. IoT. You give something like IoT hyphen demo key. Hyphen you give it. Okay, let it be. PM.
PM.
Yeah, go down. Scroll down. Add. Click on add tag.
Add tag.
And you can enter key and value. Do you know what is key value? Have you ever worked on JSON file or like unstructured? Okay, you can enter. Just like a roll number 101 name, like Dipti 102, like.
What I have to write in key 101 is it fine 101?
Yeah, you can write.
And what about value?
Any name, just like roll number name, so that yeah. And
then
you can click on this create key pair.
Create key pair.
So once you click on create key pair, it will get downloaded on your download folder.
Yes. It is downloaded.
Yeah. So now what we have to do it now, just make me host so I can explain.
Yeah, fine.
Actually, this cloud is just a game of UI and knowing this, get familiarity with the services. Once you know it, you can do it.
Okay.
Yes.
I've stopped sharing.
Yeah. Can you make me?
I typed instances on my console window. Mm-hmm. Now I see EC2 and I see EC2 feature.
EC2.
EC2. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So now, as I said, you here, what we're going to do here. Now, I will click on this file and I will simply upload this key so that I can tell that this is the authenticate or that particular key is just like a normally you might have seen when we create any account, we just create a like questions, right? Hint question, so that we can recover it in case if you forgot, like what's your pet name, first school name. Have you ever faced such situation, like while creating an account, you have they ask you to set some of the questions and answer so that it will help you to recover it. So this key is also helpful in that way only.
Sorry for interrupt. I just want to know, like I have done the same thing. I have clicked on key pair, but directly that key was generated. Nothing was asked to me.
Key is generated. How it is?
Can I show my screen?
Yeah. 1 minute. Manju ma'am, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just making yours.
So I just clicked on key pair. I think my screen is visible.
Yes.
I clicked instances and then I went to key pair directly. Or do I go to EC2?
You just click on this create key pair.
Yeah, I have just clicked on that and then this key was generated.
Yeah, it was available by the cloud by default. Some of the
no, it was not available. I have created this, okay. But that process didn't happen like Deepthi. The moment,
yeah, that's why I'm telling you. You click on this create key pair. Here, yeah. You see this create key pair on your right top action, not there, here. Create key pair, orange color.
Okay.
When you click, then you will get these options.
Okay. So I need to go for PAM.
Yeah. And you need to give the name. Then you can add a tag, whatever you want. It's just like a security key and value. So in case.
Earlier, same thing happened, I think.
Yeah, you can.
Now I have to go for create key pair.
Yeah. Click on that. So it will available. Might be the name or same. That's why it's giving an error. Already exists. You give a something unique name, maybe demo one, correct? And see here that it's downloaded IoT PAM one.
Yes.
You can delete the previous one if you want. Just checkbox, select the checkbox, and right click on that.
Right click on that.
Yeah, delete it. Type delete. And click on the delete button. So it is deleted.
Okay. So now what next we have to do?
Yeah, I'm showing that same. Can you just talk?
Yeah.
Ma'am, please make me host.
Is that okay?
Yes. Yeah. So once you got that key, you just need to upload it on the server, that instance that you have created it. You will go into click on file, upload local file. Once you click on this upload, select file. Once you click on this select file, you will get an option for just like browse. So I've selected it. This was the key that I've created earlier. And I just click on that. So it will going to be come here. E default key pair will be visible to you here. Now it means that this instance you have added the key. Once you have added a key here, then the next step will be, you will go step by step. The next step is what? The next step is right that you need to run this permission. Chmod is a permission command, means you are giving a permission to this key. So you can, if you want, I can share you this. After the class, I will going to share you the same link for the command, or you can note down also from the screen, like chmod is for permission 400, and this is the name of your key. So whatever key, like IoT demo or whatever key that you have created and downloaded, you have to run it. I am going to do the same. So once I did that, it is run successfully as I'm not getting any error here. Now the next command is what? The next command is like you need to install CDK, means you need to install that software, a bootstrap software.
Can we do little bit slow? Actually, my action is lagging behind.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm not able to open this actually. Just a second.
Yeah. Not an issue. If we are not able to complete it today, we are going to do it tomorrow. We have a time. Other rest of you, are you able to run this? Sorry.
Actually, no. Bah, I did. I uploaded that one. What do you call that? Key. Yeah, IoT underscore demo. Its name was. But after that, while giving the command chmod 400 and key pair.pem, it's giving that no such file or directory. I think. Do I need to change this name?
Yeah, you need to change the name, I said, right?
Yeah.
Based on your
my name, yes.
Yeah. I think IoT demo you created, right?
Yeah, right.
Yes, so I told you that.
Sorry. Now it's still saying ki this file or no such file or directory.
I'm demo one, I think. You type demo.
No, mine is demo. IoT underscore demo minus IoT underscore
okay.
demo.
Can you show me? I'm just making you.
Yeah, my screen. Yeah.
I'll just stop sharing 1 minute.
Actually, I'm not getting that file option and all that. What's the issue?
Just 1 minute. Yeah.
Can you see my screen?
Yes. IoT demo. Cannot access IoT demo pen. Can you upload once again?
Yeah.
Because it should not give such error. You go to that.
Override, right?
Yeah. Now rerun that. You type clear, C-L-E-A-R, clear. So it will clear your screen. Then you type that. Chmod 400.
Chmod 400, right?
Yeah.
And then IoT.
Yes.
Let's go demo. Dot PEM.
Yes.
Right.
IoT demo team is not successful. Can you go to that again and create a new key?
What? Can you please repeat what?
1 minute. Let me check.
मम्मा क्लास चल रही
है कौन नहीं आ रही है आवाज क्यों नहीं आ रही आवाज क्यों नहीं आ रही मम्मा आवाज क्यों नहीं आ रही
आ जाओ
पापा कौन आवाज क्यों नहीं आ रही है
ओके मैम व्हाइल क्रिएटिंग व्हाट नेम यू हैव गिवन while description and the name, is it the same IoT workshop one?
Yeah, an IoT workshop, I think. It was IoT workshop. How can I find that name from where?
You need to go back, I think you can't find it out. But it should be same only. You can do one thing, you can create a new key. Click on that creator and don't add any tag there. Is it
working? Why did this happen again? What's wrong with the name?
I don't know. I think I need to check it.
Do I need to create a new key pair?
Yes, I said to create a new key pair. So we can check it. because it never happens. I need to check once, like why the error is coming. Maybe the instance name are correct.
So, I think I'm creating a new key pair and I'm writing its name as Deepthi.
And don't give anything else, only Deepthi.
Only Deepthi, yeah. And private key file format is PEM.
Yeah.
After that, I'm clicking on create key pair, right?
Yeah. For other, it is working.
Okay.
Make this like that window is not coming to me actually. File option is not coming, like that option is coming from nowhere, I think. Here.
Okay. Otherwise, I need to check it why it's not working on your system, because it's working. There's nothing wrong. Deepthi.pem.
Yeah. Now it worked. Okay. Now it worked. Yeah.
Might have given the wrong name. Just check it there.
Maybe,
capital or small?
Maybe. Okay. I'll give you the control, right?
Yes.
Amit, can you see my system?
Yeah. Please show me.
I've stopped sharing.
This thing I'm getting, that file option is not coming over here.
You scroll up. Did you get the scrolling option?
This thing?
No, not this one. Why it is not coming? You press control minus. I think your... Wait. It should come. Yeah. You try to reduce it.
No, that file option is not coming.
Yeah. That's why I'm looking into that. Okay, ma'am. Click on that arrow button. Did you get that any arrow options in the top?
No, it's not there. Can I do it again?
You can just yes.
Just from IIT workshop one, I can go to open IID, right?
Yes. Create environment options. Did you not getting that? Yeah, click on that environment. Yes, create environment.
This one I can use. Or do I need to create new one?
You try to create a new one.
Okay.
Give any name. Yes. Leave the description part. Create it. Next step. And click on create. Now you are getting.
Oh, yes. I don't know earlier why it was not there.
See this arrow you are getting at the end of 9, that cloud 9. Do you see the triangle shape, small triangle shape in the left top? Beside the file, you see 9. And then you see...
That thing.
Yeah, beside that triangle. Now, when you click on that, it will get hide.
Okay.
Now it will come.
So next the earlier key IoT demo one that I can upload.
Yes, you can upload it. I think we have to see this rest of the command in the next class, because we have a maze. It will going to be end in 3 minutes. So okay, you can do one thing, but have you created the key, right? You have a key pair IoT demo. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So just once it's done, try to upload it.
Okay.
Swarnita ma'am, it is working for you?
Yes, it worked for me.
Okay, that's great. Select IoT demo 1. Download, go to the download. Yeah. Yes, it's done. Close it and type chmod 400. and the name of that key value pair. Give a space between them. It is used for a permission that you are giving a permission.
Yes, mode 400, right?
Yeah, and now give the name IoT demo 1.pam. Give as it is. No, I think I is small. I think.
In the right side, we can see that is capital one.
Okay. Yes. Can you take it small and check it?
CS mode space 400.
Yeah, IoT.
Is it?
No. Actually, ma'am, you have given the space. No, that's why it's giving an error. Space should not be there in between.
Yeah, that's what I
said. Not in between this. Between file, I am saying. IoT demo will be treated as a separate entity then. You have to create a key value pair with the name you should give without space. You create a new key value pair.
So that I can do from where?
Just go to the AWS console. Click on that AWS console. Go to the tab, Google tab.
Okay. From here?
Go to the console. Yeah, ma'am, it will going to be end, I think. We have only 1 minute.
So we are rejoining with the same meeting, right?
Yeah. Or we can do it tomorrow, the next step. Because it will take too much time. I have to run the other commands. You can go to the AWS, type AWS. Just simply type AWS console. AWS console. Click on that. Yes, sign in. Do you have an account, right? Logged in. Yes. Now on that top, you search for instances, EC2 instances. Yes, click on that first link. Yes, and scroll down, key pair. And click on this create key pair, this orange one. And when you give the name, don't give a space in between. You can use hyphen, underscore, whatever. Don't give a space. And click on this form, PEM file. And create key pair. Now you go to that window. Yes, you type. You need to upload it first. Upload it. Ma'am, only 30 seconds is there. If it disconnects, please join back on the same link.
Okay.
Yeah, now type chmod